In this video, you will see how you can add guests to a Google Calendar event with Google Apps Script. Our setup for the script. We have two events in Jane Examples calendars. She wants people to sign up to these two or to one of the two automation events. For that, we've created a simple Google form. You see they can either choose the 7th of March or the 9th of March. And here, crucial, we're collecting the email addresses of the people submitting this Google form. And the responses will be added to this specific Google Sheets form. And that's where we will be getting the answers from. So we will be working with the trigger that will listen to whenever the form is submitted. But first, we actually have to start writing our code. So there you go. We're gonna call this automation event sign up. You're free to call it whatever you want to. And now we're gonna create our first function. I chose to call this add guest, and we're using the event parameter. That is because for the submission event, we need to get certain information, like the values of that event. And in our values, in the values array, index 1, which we see here, that's index 0, 1, and 2, there you go. So what we're listening for, or what we're fetching here, is whatever's in that values array in the index 1, which is column B, that will contain the email addresses. So we will save that value to a variable that we're naming email. We're creating a second variable, and we're calling it date and time. And again, we're getting the values from the event object, and this time index 2, so that will be column C in our Google Sheets. And now we're seeing if date and time, so the date that the person chose when submitting the form, if that equals the string 7th of March at and so on and so forth, so that is exactly the text we have here. Actually, just to make sure that I don't have any typos there, I'm copying this. Or actually, I think it was correct. So in that case, I don't have to paste it. So if the person chose the 7th of March, we'll do the following. We'll create a variable called event 7th, and we'll head over to the calendar app, get events for day. So keep in mind, this is Jane's calendar. And we want to search for the specific calendar event. Now, to make sure that the date is in the format that we need to be able to search, I'm using the new date constructor here. And I'm passing in the 7th of, wait a minute, March is 3rd. Well, in JavaScript, the months start at 0, just like the indexes in the array. And then we have to, as a second parameter, pass in an object and containing the key search and the value, the exact name of our event. Here, I didn't know if it would accept the emoji, so we'll find out. So I'll be searching for that specific event in the calendar of this user, the user being Jane Example. So here, a little explanation. As you can see, the months is 0 index, so that's why March is 2 and not 3, as we humans usually refer to it. And this is the event object that we will be using, which is available since we're using the triggers. So you can either use it on the simple triggers or the installable triggers. And if we have a look at the Google Sheets events on form submit, and we scroll a little bit down, here you see the values what I'm using. So it's an array with values in the same order as they appear in the spreadsheet. That's exactly what we're using. Now we're saying event 7th in the first position in our array. Why? Because to get events for day always gives you back an array, even if there's only one event that matches that search. And we will be adding our guest and passing in the email as the person that we want to add as a guest. And now we're saying, and if the person did not choose the 7th of March, well, in that case, we need to go and fetch the event for the 9th of March and add the person to that event. So again, we're getting the events for that day. We're passing in the day we want to get the events for. So obviously, you see the from the workflow that you need the event in your calendar first in order to be able to get it. And now again, second, standing for March in JavaScript or AppScript, and 9th for the day. And here's our search term. And again, I will be just copy pasting this from our event, the title that I gave it, and adding it like so. There was an extra space that wasn't necessary. Okay, that looks good. And again, we have to add that person who signed up to that specific event. So we're using the add guest method on the event of the Google Calendar, and we're passing in the email of the person who signed up. So we saved our script. And now onto our trigger that we want to install. There you go. The function to run is @guest. There's only one in this, so that's perfectly fine. That is also fine. But here, the select event type on form submit. That's what we need for our Google form to trigger our script to run once the form has been submitted. Let's go ahead and save that. That looks good. Might take a couple of minutes, oh, script authorization failed. Ah, there's a pop-up that appeared. So we have to first authorize the script. This is also because we've never run it. We didn't run it before in a script editor. So now we have to grant the authorization to actually access the Google Calendar of the user, in this case, Jane Example. Good, so that's now saving it. Our trigger is in place. Perfect. Let's go back to our code. I would say everything looks just the way it's supposed to. Now we're seeing Adam's account, and he's submitting the form and saying he wants to join the 7th of March. Did it work? Did our script work? Let's have a look. Ah, there you go. Adam is now added to that invite. Important, he has been added. He didn't receive an invite as an email because this does not trigger an email to be sent out. Now we're also going to sign up for the 9th to see how that works. Now, if you need an invite to be sent out, I've read that you can use the advanced API of Google Calendar. I haven't done so yet myself, but I read that that might be a solution. I said this does not send out an invite, but the calendar event does appear in the calendar of the person, and they can say yes, they will be joining. So that worked out perfectly fine, even including our emoji. Let's have a look at how the Google Sheets looks. So we see the email addresses, the dates they signed up to. Let's look at the trigger. So you can click on the three dots and then say executions, and you'll see a little bit more information at what time the triggers ran and the duration. Let me know, did you learn something through this video? In that case, then go ahead and leave us a like. And did you subscribe already? I can't see it. So please go ahead, check if you subscribe. If not, then do so that you don't miss out on any of our video tutorials.